While this country's political debate bangs on about asylum seekers, new and disturbing allegations have emerged around war criminals. Federal police are said to be evaluating quote-unquote credible evidence claiming that Sri Lankans, some with dubious pasts, are living respectable lives here in Australia. Hugh Rimmington takes up the story, and we warn you that you may find some images confronting.
Something dreadful happened 2 years ago in northeastern Sri Lanka.
We received orders from the top to kill some of those who surrendered. All regiments received the orders unofficially.
In May 2009, the last holdouts of the Tamil Tigers militia were trapped on a narrow strip of beach with 130,000 civilians they were using as human shields. Britain's Channel 4 has interviewed Sri Lankan government soldiers who claim their own colleagues unleashed a final slaughter.
They shot people at random, stabbed people, raped them, cut out their tongues. I saw a lot of small, innocent children getting killed in large numbers. I saw people soaked in blood.
The United Nations believes 40,000 civilians were killed and both government troops and the Tamil Tigers committed war crimes. Now a senior Australian legal body has told the Federal Police and the Commonwealth Director of Public Prosecutions people now living in Australia require investigation.
What we've sent is evidence and material supporting that evidence of war crimes.
Former New South Wales Attorney General John Dowd submitted the alleged evidence.
We are not commenting about any name of any person. We've simply provided information, as is our duty, to the police.
One of Sri Lanka's most senior military figures is now High Commissioner to Australia.
They don't know whom they're dealing with, unfortunately.
Former Sri Lankan Navy Chief Admiral Tissara Samarasinghe denies Sri Lanka committed war crimes.
These are baseless and false allegations.
Sri Lanka says the crushing of the Tamil rebellion was the greatest hostage rescue operation in history. Mr. Samarasinghe blames civilian deaths on the Tamil separatists and says there is no case for Sri Lanka to answer.
Every step to avoid civilian casualties was taken.
But the new Australian report adds to growing international pressure.
Clearly, it gives further weight to the need for a war crimes tribunal at an international level.
It is an internal conflict which requires an internal assessment. There is no requirement to investigate internationally what happened in Sri Lanka.
Britain, Canada, the United Nations and numerous human rights groups have called for greater international action. The Greens claim Australia's voice has been muted because the government is so dependent on Sri Lanka's help in shutting down Tamil boat movements towards our shores. In the meantime, Mr. Samarasinghe, who was once an aide to Prince Charles, awaits the next move.
Do you have any fear about a police investigation?
Absolutely no. When you have not done a mistake, you have absolutely no fear.
Hugh Rimmington reporting there.